Hi friends, I'm Cassie Kozarkov, a recovering statistician, and today I'm going to help you understand the philosophical divide between Bayesian statistics and frequentist statistics. And in fact, this is going to be a medical diagnostic test to tell you which one you are. You ready? Okay. I've got a US quarter here. Nothing special, no shenanigans. It has a heads, that's the one with the head, and a tails, and I'm going to flip this coin. I'm going to flip this coin until it lands heads or tails in my hand. So if it lands on its side or it falls on the floor, I'm going to redo this thing. So before I begin, what is the probability that this coin will land heads up on my palm? And let's round that to one decimal place so that you don't get smart. I hope you're saying 50% or a half. I agree with you, 50%. Okay, now I'm going to flip it. Okay. Next question for you. What is the probability that this coin is heads up on my palm? What's that you're saying? What's the probability? What's the probability that this coin is heads up? You might be saying one of two things now. Some of you might be saying, for you, Cassie, it's whatever it is for you, and for us, it's 50%. Those of you who like that answer, you have aligned yourself with the Bayesian perspective. Others of you might be saying, the coin, Cassie, is up heads or tails already. There is no probability about it. That thing has landed. And so it's a stupid question, actually. If it is up heads, the answer is 100%, and if it is up tails, the answer is 0%. I don't know which one it is, but still, there is an actual correct answer, and there is no probability about it. That is the frequentist perspective. Now, I want to say about Bayesians, they're not insane. They're not like, oh, it's in some undetermined state, it's not Schrodinger's coin here. They understand that the coin has landed. They understand that just like the frequentist has understood it. They're just not interested in that. They are interested in their own perspective, from their point of view. In their opinion, it is 50%. The frequentist, on the other hand, cares very much about the true answer. The truth has already been fixed in the universe. And if the truth is heads, it's 100%. If the truth is tails, it's 0%. And their analysis is oriented on that truth, not on their evolving opinion. Now, when I show you how the coin has landed, and in this case, I don't know if you can see it, but in this case, it is tails up. Now I ask you again, what's the probability that this coin is up heads? And the answer should be, from both the frequentist and the Bayesian, 0%. The difference is when the coin has landed, but you haven't seen the answer. The Bayesian will say, from my perspective, 50%. The frequentist will say, the actual answer is 0 or 100. There's no probability. I just don't know the answer. Now, which one should you go with? Which philosophical perspective makes sense? They're both terrible in their own ways, and they're both beautiful in their own ways. See, Bayesian can never be wrong, because it's always their opinion. They take a starting opinion, they see some evidence, they get a new opinion. That's still their opinion. Doesn't matter if that opinion has nothing to do with everyone else's opinion. It's just a sensible way of updating your opinion with data. But is there a good standard for how you might collaborate between opinions? It's all about you, and it's all about your own perspective. And there is no notion of what are the chances that my method gives me the wrong answer. There is no wrong answer. Frequentists, on the other hand, want to say, if I were to repeat this procedure many, 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 many times, some of those times, I would guess correctly. Some of those times, I wouldn't. If I guessed heads, I would get it right 50% of the time. If I did it frequently many times. They have a notion of getting it right. They have a notion of, did I guess the truth properly? Bayesians don't have that notion. I had an opinion, meh. I updated it reasonably with data, now I've got a new opinion, meh. If that's what you want, Bayesians for you. If, on the other hand, you want to talk about what are the chances that my method hits the right answer, if I do this method over and over, if you want this idea of the method's quality, I'm doing my analysis at a particular quality level, as captured by power and significance, if you know those frequentist things, then the frequentist method is for you. The way I like to think about whether to go Bayesian or to go frequentist is statistics is the discipline of changing your mind under uncertainty. What would you like to change your mind about? Would you like to take your personal opinion, add data to it, and then see how your opinion should reasonably change? Well, then you want to go Bayesian. If you're thinking about it in terms of, here is an action that I'm happy to take by default under ignorance, I've got no beliefs, but, you know, I've got a favorite action, then does my evidence change my mind about that action? Is the evidence strong enough to convince me not to take this action? Or should I just go ahead with the action? If you're framing things that way, then you want to be in a frequentist perspective, because there you can think about what is the method's quality with respect to making you stupidly leave your default action? What is the method's quality with respect to you not leaving your action when you should? Depending on what kind of reasoning you're here for, you might want to go Bayesian or you might want to go frequentist. For more information, check out the link in the description below.